It's very important, this conference, because we see that debt issues are a problem in a lot of countries and is a major problem at the European Union, and also because debt has been used as a blackmailing system in order to make all the adjustments which the governments and the European institutions want to do in order to deregulate the labor market, in order to make people more and more in a situation of poverty. And, of course, a major attack to the social state and public services. This is the excuse which is being used by all the European institutions and governments in Europe in order to make a real and major social transformation at European society and in our countries. So we have to break this blackmailing system. We need to break it, and the only way and the main way in this moment is to through the debt. Debt is not the key issue if we have the strength to renegotiate it and to make it in such a way that we have available resources to invest in growth, in the generation and creation of employment and other important issues.
So, which of the proposals made in this conference would you highlight?
The major proposal is that this debt is not sustainable. We know that. So we need to renegotiate it as soon as possible. The sooner, the best. Because, as I said, the European countries, and mainly those who have been more affected with the crisis, are socially and economically devastated. So we need to do it as soon as possible, because since the beginning of the financial crisis, the financial system didn't pay anything concerning the crisis. So restructuring the debt, renegotiating it, is a way of putting the pressure on the financial markets, those who were in fact the responsible for the crisis and not on people.
And how do you see the positions or the chances of the EL vis-à-vis other European political forces for these European elections?
I think that the European left is doing a lot of progress in terms of bringing a left alternative. Over the last years, a lot of things have been done in the sense of gathering not only the political parties, which are at the left as we know it, but also the ecological left, feminist left, all the left, the trade unions. We need to gather all the forces, and I think that European left is doing that work. It's a process, but it's a good process till now, and we have a candidate for the European Commission in order to know that when people will listen for the debates for the European Commission, that the voice of the left is not Martin Schulz, no, the voice of the left is Alexis Tsipras. Martin Schulz has been always on the side of the right wing, not on the side of the people. So we need to have that voice, we need to have our campaign, our proposal, and I think it's quite clear that we are making progress.